Russian hawk moths. That's right, kids. Today I'm going to tell you all about this species of insect, Smerinthus caecus, the northern eyed hawk moth. This story starts with tiny little baby caterpillars. These babies just hatched from their eggs. The tiny little green things here are eggs, and the little wormy things are the first instar caterpillars that are hatching from them. I put them inside a little plastic box with some willow. I usually use cricket tubs for the babies. Willow, or salix, is described as the primary host plant of this species and thus in captivity is recommended that we raise them on willow tree. Another record mentions poplar tree or populus. In captivity, Smerinthus species are usually very easy to raise and fast growing, and there are many species of them worldwide. Very quickly, the caterpillars grew to the second instar. In the second instar, they are much more elongated and have a small, creamy, yellow-white bands that run alongside their bodies. So the caterpillars are now starting to grow bigger, and therefore I started considering putting them in a bigger container. I'm giving them a space upgrade so that they have more room per individual larva. I will not run out of food that quickly, so therefore I'm placing them in a bigger container. And there was the third instar. The third instar caterpillars have a more triangular head that is usual for many Smerinthinae species. Once again, I upgraded my babies to an even bigger box. Now that was more appropriate for their size that was ever increasing. Now in the third instar, their consumption of willow leaf quickly begins to increase. And then the caterpillars grew to their fourth and fifth instars. And now the first specimens were close to being fully grown. These are the fifth and final instars of Smerinthus caecus, consuming willow leaves in their box. Because of their size, shape and color, they are camouflaged excellently among the foliage. In total, it took me about 5 weeks to raise these from eggs to pupa. Maybe I could have done it faster, since it was very early in spring and a little bit colder than usual. The warmer the temperatures, the faster your caterpillars will grow. Regardless, I had little losses of this species of eyed hawk moth. Thank you. Hello, my friends. Please ignore the wind. Today we have some very good news. Do you see these two caterpillars here in the middle? They keep walking around on the bottom of the container. And that's because they are going to pupate. They're going to turn into moths. Let me show you. As you can see, these two caterpillars are in the wandering phase. They've also changed color. Compare the color of this individual here in my hand. For example, next to this individual, can you see the different color of green? When they want to pupate, they become darker and unable to sit still on their food plants. If I would place it here, they would just wander away. And that's because these caterpillars, they pupate underground. So what happens to these pre-pupa is they become very restless. They start wandering around on the bottom of their container, looking for a place actually to burrow in the soil and pupate. See? It starts moving again, compared to the other caterpillars who are sitting still. And if your caterpillars start walking around like this, aimlessly, it's a sign that they may want to pupate. So we're going to take these pre-pupa and turn them into pupa. Most people prefer to pupate caterpillars in soil, but personally I don't. Personally, I prefer to use cricket tubs with paper towel in it that gives them a soft layer of tissue to pupate on. What I do is I take one or two pre-pupal larvae per box. I don't add too many of them since they could disturb each other. Eventually, if you wait a week or two, the larvae will settle down, become immobile and eventually start to pupate. At a later stage, one can collect the pupa from the containers. As you can see, a lot of pupa had formed over time, and here you can see me collecting them. Now, typically this species has one or two generations per year. However, a second generation is quite rare, and it seems that they have a bimodal emergence pattern in which most individuals overwinter in their pupal stage and hatch the consecutive spring. So I didn't really expect these pupa to hatch until the next year. So what I did is I stored them away in my outdoors breeding cage for a while, expecting to overwinter them in a layer of soft and absorbing vermiculite. Ignore the other moths that you see in the video. However, I was wrong. In a few weeks' time, I saw a moth hatch from his pupa. That's a surprise, since second generations of Smerinthus caecus happen less frequently than the pupa just overwintering until next spring. So that was a pleasant surprise. The imagos of Smerinthus caecus have beautiful eye spots that they flaunt whenever they feel threatened. I apologize for poking it, but I thought it was important to show you this typical behavior. So eventually more moths started hatching. The moths are very well camouflaged with their wings closed, and in the resting position, once they become active, they reveal their beautifully colored hindwings. According to my sources, they are found in grassy mixed boreal forests, especially in clearings and among streams, swamps and lake fringes with a good growth of salix and betula. Farther east in Siberia, it's reported that the species does not only occur in mixed forests, but also in small and isolated patches of deciduous woodlands in the steppe belt, Novosibirsk province, for example. However, salix must also be present. That's what my source that I'm reading right now reads. Reportedly, it's also found in Russia, from the outskirts of St. Petersburg and Moscow to the Urals, across western Siberia, northeastern Kazakhstan and to the Altai Mountains. Recent information also indicates this species may be present in Belarus and Finland. although rare. In the wild, these moths fly from the end of May to the beginning of July, usually in one generation per year. Second generations can occur in some localities, although this seems uncommon. That's why I was so surprised to have my moths hatching so early in the season. These moths have no functioning mouthparts and do not feed. They live for 1 to 2 weeks and then die after pairing and laying eggs. Tonight is a warm night, so this should have the intended result. I must be quiet because my neighbors are sleeping. Let's see how people are going to think I'm crazy when they see me at night. Let's use my phone for a while. Oof. Technology, we have to love it, don't we? There we go. This is where I keep the moth cages. As you can see, here are some overwintering pupa and cocoons who are ready to hatch in spring. Nothing has hatched yet, but here are the hawk moths. And do you see this? Look at that. This is a pairing of the Smerinthus caecus. Now, one pair has paired. In the top we have many more. We have many more males and females. Oops. Oops. See, there's many more. But these haven't paired yet. They are not showing interest yet. I'm not sure why. I think I have too much females and too little males. But maybe later tonight. Who knows? That sure looks good, right? I opened the cage a little bit so we can see it. But at this point, you definitely don't want to disturb them too much. So this is the most acceptable footage I can make without breaking up the pairing, which will not be good, but look. Looks like we're going to have some nice eggies of these hawks. Here you can see some active females at night laying eggs. They seem to lay them all over the cage walls easily. And then finally, when you have your eggs, you can start the life cycle all over again. Isn't that fun? As a breeder, that's my end game. This was just a short and informational video about the life cycle of Smerinthus caecus in captivity. I hope you have enjoyed watching this. Last but not least, a gentle reminder, YouTube does not support my channel and I do not make any money from my videos. This channel runs on donations from my fans for 100%. Consider contributing to my show. Donations from my fans make my breeding projects possible. With your help, I will film the life cycle of your favorite insects. Thank you and goodbye.